He can still be happy about heaven. I know in 2012 we deeper than that now. We deeper than that. Amen. We want to get the mysteries of God. Amen. But behold, I show you a mystery. Everybody that called on his name does not know him. Amen. That's a mystery. Amen. Everybody that say, Lord, Lord, shall not enter in. That's a mystery. But I know that there's a God somewhere waiting on me. So he working on my building. Amen. If this old building might be leaning. It might be leaning because of health problem. It might be leaning because of sin problem. But whatever you leaning on, you got to make sure you lean on the Lord's side. I'm going to put my hand.
His face, amen.
I want to be able to see the one that died for me. I want to be able to see the one that set me free. Sometimes I just want to see his face. Amen. And I know some of y'all are all fired up to hear the third installment in the Sense series, making sense of it all. Well, you about to hear it, amen. You about to hear it, because in order for to see God's face, look at your bulletin. The first thing I need to see his hand, amen. I need to see the hand of God. I need to see God move like he ain't never moved before. We're living in a day and an age where we need to see the hand of God. Sometimes the way it looks, the hand of God need to write on the wall like he wrote for Daniel. Amen. Many, many people, amen. He wrote a word of destruction. Sometimes we need to see that so we can know that God is a good God, but he ain't playing with you. Amen. We need to understand that the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. We need to see the hand of God. We need to understand that when an earthquake and diverse places, amen, when there are wars and rumors of wars, when there are floods and pestilences, that's the hand of God. Sometimes we need to stop praying against the hand of God. You don't know how many people that got saved in the midst of the earthquake, amen. You don't know how many people that turned to God in the face of the wars, amen. In the midst of the flood, we don't understand why New Orleans flooded again, amen. It only been 7 years, but somebody needed to see the hand of the Almighty God. And when you begin to see the hand of God, even if it's in the midst of judgment, it'll make you fall on your knees. It'll make you cry, "Our Father that art in heaven, hallowed be thy name." When you ain't called his name in ages, trouble will make you call his name. You need to know every now and again, you need to see the hand of God. Then you need to see the hand of God in the midst, amen, in the midst of your trouble. Sometimes you got to know this about God. God is not a man that he will look at you and not come rescue you. Sometimes there are men and women in this world that will walk right by your situation and won't look to the right or to the left. Don't be troubled. Don't you worry. Don't you fret. My God is still coming back and will save you yet. You got to know that same hand of God that can bring forth judgment to a sinful world will see his child in need and never ever leave him wanting. Never ever leave him alone. No. No, not alone. Come to the garden on the morning where the dew is still fresh on the roses and the buzz I hear. Woo, the hand on my shoulder, the hand is lifting me up from where I am, from where I fell. They're taking me where I belong. It is none other than the hand of the Lord. You got to see the hand of the Lord. Still in trouble when everybody else can turn back on you. Your situation is over and done. They're putting dirt on you. The undertaker closed in the coffin. The preacher is committing the body to acid dust to dust. It's still too late to see the hand of God. The hand of God. I love this picture on the bulletin. You know where this picture on the bulletin come from? It comes from Michelangelo and the Sistine Chapel. The hand of God. I worked on this text sermon. I ain't gonna preach, but can I give you a little bit of it? Michelangelo was working on a work all over there for the Pope. And the Pope told him, "I got something else for you to do." Michelangelo said, "No, I don't want to do nothing else, because this is gonna make my legacy." But he began to say to the Pope, I'ma give in to what you said. So for years and years, he laid on his back, looking up to this Sistine Chapel, and he began to paint a picture. And the picture he began to paint, it was Adam being created. It was Adam weak still, laying still, not having the life that should have been breathed into his body, not receiving a touch from the hand of the Lord. And God reached down his hand. And when he reached down his hand, Adam could barely muster enough strength to lift his hand. But I guarantee you, when you see the hand of God, you see the hand of God in the mirror every day. You see the hand of God. You see the hand of God in your breathing in and out. You see the hand of God in your children and in your children's children. You see the hand of God. And when you see the hand of God, if you can just lift up, lift up, lift up your hands, oh, you case, oh, you grace, the everlasting, lift it up, the everlasting doors, and let the King of Glory come in. That's what Adam did. Adam lifted his hand toward God. And when Adam lifted up his hand toward God, God lifted him. God lifted him up out of his situation. God began to breathe in him a breath of life. God began to give him a power. Amen. See, there's a power, amen, in God that God wants to transfer to you. You can't traverse. You can't make it. You can't make your journey if you don't have the power of God. Jesus. You won't get to point A. You won't get to point B. You won't make it into heaven. You can't make it across the street. You can't make it the next week. You can't make it to the next paycheck. Telephone disconnect. Baby, need a pair of shoes. What in the world am I going to do? You can't make it without seeing the hand of God. When you see the hand of God, the hand of God coming down, you're going to reach out and grab it. You sure can have it. God got a miracle for you. When you need the hand of God, when you're laying down on your last breath, when you're in the midst of a worse situation, I see the hand of God. I see the hand of God coming. What's left of my strength, I'll give as an offering. What's left of my health, I'll give as a praise. My last breath, I'll give God, because I can only see the hand of God. If I see it, I can have it. If I see it, I can have it. God. And when you see the hand of God, can I tell you, and I'm getting ready to go, when you see the hand of God coming for you, the hand of God don't come without. Can I tell you, there are some things you can get, they tell you some assembly required. There are some things you can get, you must add battery. There are some things you can make at the store that you got to add water, sugar, flour, or anything. But can I tell you, Jesus, God, don't come with nothing but all that he has. All to him I owe. All to him I give. And don't you believe that God will give you the same thing back. When God come to touch you, when God come to touch you, when God come to touch you, he touches you with his power. He touches you with his love. He touches you with his joy. He touches you with his peace. Look what it did for Adam. He breathed into Adam. He trusted him and he breathed into him. And I tell you, that word breathe right there, it talks about wind. That word wind, if you go over to Acts 2, in the upper room, there came a sound like a mighty rushing wind. And I tell you, that word breathe in Genesis 2, It means spirit. Can I tell you in Acts 2, that word means spirit. Can I tell you that when God breathed into Adam, that meant power. Can I tell you in Acts 2, when God filled them with the Holy Ghost, that meant power. Can I tell you in Genesis 2, that when he got power, he became a living, breathing soul. And can I tell you in Acts 2, when they got the power, they became a living, breathing church. Can I tell you in Acts 2, that Adam was able to carry on God's will? Can I tell you in the book of Acts that you shall be witnesses in Judea, in Jerusalem, and in Samaria? Can I tell you with the touch of the power they were able to carry on God's word? Can I tell you that even though over there in Acts 2, Adam got the word that he was to have dominion and power over everything? When you got the power in Acts 2, you got dominion and power over the devil. We wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principality and spiritual wickedness and high places. You need your power, you need a touch from the Lord. Let me go back to Adam for a minute. Adam had the power. Adam received the touch, but Adam fell into disobedience. But that's all right. That's all right. Because I see, Adam had already seen the hand of the Lord. And when Adam saw the hand of the Lord, even though he had to go from the garden, he never left the presence of God. And God walked with him for 900 some years. And then he walked with his sons. And his sons after that, he walked with Methuselah 900 some years. He walked with Moses. He walked with Noah 700 some years. He walked with Abraham, but in the midst of the walk with Abraham, somebody said, in the midst of the walk, Abraham saw the Lord. And when he saw the hand of God, God said, you see my hand in this first generation, 41 generations after you. 41 generations after you, there shall come another that shall have all power, that shall have all strength. That hand shall be lifted up against sin. That hand shall be lifted up. And can I tell you, that hand that came down to 42 generations, that hand was none other than the hand of Jesus. The hand that held Mary's hand. The hand that turned water into wine. That hand that touched blinded eyes and they didn't see. That hand that stopped the funeral procession, amen, and raised the dead. That hand that cleansed the leper. That hand that fed 5,000. That hand.